throw every newborn Hebrew boy into the Nile River, but you may let the girls live. The Pharaoh's words echoed in the young woman's mind as the midwife directed her in the final moments of giving birth to her third child. For the last few months, she'd been praying for God's blessing that her newborn child would not be a boy. Please, she prayed to the God of Joseph, Israel, and Abraham. She gripped her husband's hand and gave one final push as she gave birth to the newborn. Please, not a boy, she silently begged while she heard the newborn baby cry out as it took its first breath. The midwife quickly soothed the baby and wrapped it up, and with a look of hesitation and sorrow, she handed the baby to its mother. It's a boy, she said, with a look of sadness on her face. Good morning, Calvary, and welcome to your word for the day. My name is Pastor Mitch, and today we're going to be looking at Exodus chapter 2, verses 1 through 10, specifically the birth of Moses. Today's text is a bit long for me to read in today's video, but as you read through the stories of Exodus, it's always a good reminder that these are not just bedtime stories or made-up fairy tales. These are real stories about real people with real emotions. We can't always know exactly how they felt or reacted from the text, but we can empathize with them as humans who've also gone through pain and struggle and doubt. Have you ever had a newborn in your house? They aren't the quietest of humans, and they only get louder as their lungs get stronger. And after Moses was born, his mother hid him for the next 3 months. Each day she woke up in fear of her life and the life of her newborn son. Each time he cried out, her mind immediately began thinking about who might be passing by her house, who might have overheard. Was it one of the slave masters who were there to carry out Pharaoh's commands? This must have seemed like such an unfortunate time to have a child. Maybe she even had doubts about whether God even cared or wanted her baby to live. And it's easy for us who know the story to look at these events and know that everything turns out decently as God has an amazing plan for Moses. But if you place yourself in her shoes, if you see it from her point of view, we don't yet know anything past verse 10. So after doing her best to hide him for a few months, Moses' mother decides that she can no longer hide him without putting him and the rest of her family in jeopardy. And so she makes the scariest decision of her life, and she places her newborn into a waterproof basket and places him along the banks of the Nile. And there, we get to see the beginning of God taking this horrible situation and turning it into something that would end up being a blessing for the entire nation. See, God had a plan and a purpose for Moses when he was born, and I believe that God has a plan and a purpose for your life too. The plan that God has for you doesn't start or stop at a certain age. You're never too young to begin living out the plan that God has for you, and you're never too old. If you are still breathing, that means God is not done with you yet. So my challenge for you today is to simply ask God what steps He wants you to begin taking. You don't need to know the whole plan or how it all fits together. It might mean that God calls you to overseas missions, or that He simply calls you to see your workplace as your mission. It might mean that God wants you to use your gifts to share the gospel message with a sermon as a pastor, or with a class of kids as a teacher, with your life group as one of our life group leaders, or with a coffee and a smile as one of our greeters. Simply ask God to speak to you and then take the steps of faith needed to begin living that calling out in your life. Thank you for tuning into your word for the day. Like and share this video, and we will see you next week.